Hello guys, I'm Light the Gnome and welcome back to this chaotic Gnome Forest. Today we're going on with the plot of the episode 3. Let's go. Okay, we obtained the card. So yes, we can go to the studio one now. Let's go! Move. Employ area. Studio main gate, ok. No, ok, we don't need to talk with you. Let's go on. No. I think here. Oh my god, what a long road. Hello? No. Back. Ah, maybe we need to examine. The entrance to Studio One. This is the studio where they found Jackhammer's body.
Let's go in and check it out, Nick.
I wonder if this card key we borrow from the dressing room will work. It opened.
Alright, we're in.
She's way too happy for someone visiting a crime scene. Well, I will be too. Don't mind me. Have you... No, you don't have anything to say. Don't mind me. We are going inside. Let's go. Okay. What is it? You're real quiet all of a sudden.
Doesn't it give you a shiver, Nick? That white tape. It's so surreal.
Well, the evil magistrate did die here. And the steel samurai killed him. The murder weapon was the samurai spear. Sound pretty real to me. No, poor baby. Okay, examined. Wow. They did all the sagoma of the samurai costume. They outlined where Jackhammer's body lay with tape. His body was found still inside the Evil Magistrate costume. I guess that's why the head part looks like a helmet. Funny, I expected a spear stabbing would leave at least a few blood stains. I guess the costume must have absorbed most of it. Ooh, wow. Okay.
What's this?
That's for reflecting light. They call it reflecting screen or something like that. The assistant hold it during filming.
Hmm.
What? What are your enthusiasm for the thing of entertainment?
Well, lighting is fine, but I want to be the director, or maybe the steel samurai.
I think she's being serious. Oh, I would love to know what story would you write with samurai. I want to read the samurai fanfiction of Maya, indeed.
Look, a ladder!
That's a step ladder.
So, what's the difference? You need to stop judging things based on a narrow-minded cultural assumption, Nick.
Right. Sorry. This girl is out there. Okay. I mean, there is a difference between the normal ladder and the step ladder. In the step, you have step, while in the normal ladder, you climb it without the step. Well, okay.
Wow, look at that camera. That must cost a ton.
Yeah, so don't touch it.
Wow, it's silver than I thought.
Hey, who is it? I don't know what voice do. Hey, you, not touching that. Ah, oopsie. sorry, my partner is kind of, you know.
You know? No, I don't know.
Who are you? Okay, a voice for Penny. I'm so used to do voice for men that I don't know what voice do for another little girl.
Umi, I'm an assistant here. I help with props and stuff, moving them around, ordering new ones, and etc. etc. We're lawyers representing Mr. Will Powers.
Oh, your people.
Eh? Oh, Will Powers. Whoopee. Okay, get it. I don't envy you guys one bit. But do what you can do for... I don't know how to read this acronym in English. WP WP. Do what you can do for Will, okay? I'm gonna call him Will. I'm sorry. He'd never hurt a fly. He has to be innocent.
Don't worry, leave it to us.
Talk. The day of the crime. Will you tell me something about the day of the murder?
Yes, I was in the studio the whole day. I was the only assistant on staff that day, you see.
Only one assistant?
Yes, well, the studio isn't doing so well right now. And yesterday was only rehearsal for our action sequences.
Oh, I see.
I didn't point it out the other time we saw this artwork, but the face of the old lady, wow.
In the morning we went through the action sequences in the employee area. Will and Emmer were there, along with everyone else.
The employer area, that's where Power dressing room is, right?
Yes, that's the place. After eating lunch there, Mr. Hammer went to Studio One. Then I saw Will go into his dressing room. But I didn't see either of them after that.
Will Power. Did you know that Mr. Power was sleeping in his room?
No, I wouldn't go in there unless I had some urgent message for him. I mean, it's his private... What kind of a girl do you think I am?
What kind? No, I'm sure you're a fine girl. Sorry. So much for getting a confirmation of Power alibi.
What do we do, Nick? We haven't found anything. If Will was the only one who came onto the studio, then he has to be the killer. They haven't have a photograph. Sorry, I know you're busy.
Not really.
Actually, there's been something bothering me. Ha-ha! Ha-ha! That's what I'm talking about. A clue. A lead.
Well, I don't know about that, but that day, just after noon, I sensed someone was here.
You sensed?
Yes, several times.
Some other studio employees, maybe?
No, I don't think so. The only thing we had scheduled was an action scene run through. I was the only assistant here that day. I have a feeling it was someone from outside.
Really?
But wait, if someone had come in here, wouldn't that security lady have noticed them?
Yeah, you're right.
I'm sorry, I don't have any better information than that.
No, thanks. That helps us a lot. Anything helps. Let's go put the security lady on the spot.
Thank you, Penny. Actually, Penny is the name of one of my waifus. I played some years ago Stardew Valley, and Penny was the woman I chose to love for the rest of the game. If you didn't play Stardew Valley at least once in your life, I can assure that it's a beautiful experience. Do it. Sensing someone. So you sensed that someone other than the regular film crew was in the studio?
Yes, I think.
I think doesn't cut it in a witness testimony.
Nick, what about that security lady? If someone else came into the studio, she must have seen them.
Indeed. We need to talk to her, but still, let me analyze the rest. Look like a backdrop for a stage. This must be used in the Steel Samurai show.
Of course, that's the Mountain New Fujiyama.
Doesn't the Steel Samurai take place in old Tokyo? Can you even see Mount Fuji from there?
I don't think so, but still. Not old Tokyo, Nick. Neo old Tokyo.
Oh, right. No clues here. No clues here. Okay, I guess we can go back. Okay, let's go to the security lady. Studio main gate.
What? You're still here? Really? You look as though you've seen a ghost.
Okay. Talk to us, the assistant claim.
What? I saw that suspicious look on your face.
I wanted to ask you again about yesterday. You came here at 1 PM, correct? And the estimated time of Hammer death was 2.5. Are you sure that Powers was the only one to go through here between those times?
Sure as can be. But we have witnesses who think there was someone from outside here that day.
What? You lady. You're hiding something, I know for sure.
Are you absolutely sure you were here watching the whole time? Mom? Who was it? Who told you that? Who dare question me? Eek! Alright, you better tell me and tell me quick, you speaky-haired cretin. Someone been complaining about the work I do, huh?
I mean, how old are you? Shouldn't you be on, well...
We were just talking to the assistant in Studio One.
Her! She's not even a full-time employee!
All you young...
Okay, she's... Okay. Somebody... what? She left. Talking about stunning the aggressor. Okay, she ran fast. She left.
Well, Nick, this is our chance to do what we can without her looking over our shoulder.
Ooh, examine the PC. Oh my god, that bird again. Stop. No, I hate that sound. Stop. The computer that ran the studio security camera. It's so strange, this sound of bird. It triggers me.
Nick, maybe we can see that photo of Powers with his computer.
Yeah, maybe. Should I try the computer? Try it. Let's go. Okay, let's give it a try.
You know how to work these things, Nick?
Oh, yes, this game is a bit old, even the PC is a bit old, so I think not everybody knows how to use a PC in this time that took place. Oh my god, somebody... Shut up, bird, please. Stop. Looks like I just have to enter a few numbers. Let's see. First, I need the date of the murder. It looks like the camera turned on at 1 PM that day. 1 That was when the security lady arrived at the guard station. Please enter the number of the security. I don't know. There, entered.
Nothing happened.
Huh? Maybe I got the number wrong.
Maybe we should go look in at that camera again?
Oops. Okay. Let's go to the camera. This one. Hey, there's a camera here. Okay. We have the number, guys! We have the number. Okay. There's a number plate on the camera. ST1307. Okay. This must be the camera ID number. Okay, let's go, let's go. Before the old lady return. The computer data, okay. Maybe. I should try the computer, try it. Okay. Let's go. This one. There, entered.
Hey, it printed out the data for that day.
Let's see what we got. Oh. Huh?
Why is this a picture of Willpower?
Well, he is the one who always wear that suit. I guess that why the security lady thought it was him.
I don't imagine the detective was very happy with this photo's evidence.
Well, in the photo, the person is not walking straight. Seems more like... I don't think it's Will. I think that costume was more heavy for the person that was inside.
Hmm? Something printed on the back.
Huh? October 15, 2 p.m. Photo 2.
What does that mean?
Maybe there's a photo data from that day?
Nope, that's the only one in the computer.
Power's photo? They can the gate between the entrance and the studio. Okay.
Hey, 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 Nick! Can we use this photo as evidence for the trial?
Yeah. Let's go. Can we steal? We always steal when we do the investigation. And this is indeed stealing without consent. Steal. With the power of the attorney, we can do everything. We can also steal the evidence.
We'll put that security lady in her place with this.
Right, we'll put her in her place.
Hey, that's what I said. Anyway, let's show her this photo and see what she say.
Wait, let's not.
Why not?
It's never a good idea to reveal your hand to the enemy too soon. Ooh, Phoenix. Wow, Phoenix, I didn't expect this. So strategy.
Nick, you're craftier than I gave you credit for. Why, you could be the next evil magistrate.
Hey, why do I have to be the villain?
Relax, it was just a joke. So, are we done for today?
I think this photo is what we needed for the trial. Still, it'd be better if we had some idea who the real killer was. Maybe it's really is that security lady? We... To be continued...
Gasp.
Yes, let's save. Okay. We only need that photo. Are we sure? Courtroom, We are already doing the. Oh, whoa, okay. No, it's not true. No, guys, I saw him. Why is Edgeworth here? Why is still Edgeworth? Okay, I was thinking there would have been another prosecutor this time, but well, okay. Oh no. Okay, hello, motherfucker. I hate you so much. I didn't want to see you so soon. Court is now in session for the trial of Mr. Will Powers. The prosecution is ready, Your Honor. The defense is ready, Your Honor. Very well. Mr. Edgeworth, your opening statement, please. The prosecution will show the court that 2:30 p.m. on the October 50, the defendant, Mr. Willpower, killed the fellow actor Jack Hammer in Studio One of Global Studio. Is my impression or is he a little depressed? It is impossible for anyone else to have committed this heinous crime. The evidence presented during the trial will all point to this fact. I see. Very well. I would like to move on to testimony. Mr. Edgeworth, the prosecution may call its first witness. Very well. I call a most familiar face, Detective Gumshoe, to the stand. I don't know. I'm voicing him. Super depressed because I remember that was what Gumshoe said the other episode, that he was sad. And I feel I can feel his soul right now. Okay. Detective, if you would briefly describe this case to the court. Yes, sir. I'll explain with the guide map here. To understand this case, it's important to grasp the layout of the studio, see? This here is the employee area. Ooh, I don't remember this part. The actor did a run through to the action scene during the morning here. This is the main gate to the studio. The security lady that works at the studio was here at 1 p.m. on that day. Past the security station, there is a gate, see? Past that are the studios. And here it is, Studio One. This is the scene of the murder, where the body was found. Now, on the day of the murder, October 50, there were only three people. The victim, Jack Hammer. The defendant, Will Powers, and a young woman, the production assistant. All the product staff were on the employee area until noon. Then, after lunch, the victim, Jack Hammer, went to the Studio One. Right after that, 1 p.m., the security lady got to the guard station. Now, jump ahead to later that day, 5 p.m. The product staff came to Studio One to perform a rehearsal. Nevertheless, to say the rehearsal was cancelled. The time of death was 2:30 p.m. The samurai spear found lodged in the victim's chest was the murder weapon. That's the case, in brief. Anyone like to hear that again? Should I listen to that whole thing again? Keep it. I think I can probably remember that. So the murder weapon was a spear? Oh, medieval. Listen who is talking. Your medieval too, judge. Samurai spear. The spear was found stuck in the chest of the victim. Your Honor. This case is quite simple if you ask one question. And that question is, what did the security lady at the guard station see?
Understood.
Let's call the security officer to the stand. Hello there. Will the witness declare her name?
My, aren't you a handsome fellow?
Oh no. No, she's flirting with Edward.
I'm afraid I'm a bit flustered.
Edward, why aren't you happy that a nice old lady is flirting with you in court?
Your name, please.
Oh, dear, no need for you to be embarrassed. Just call me Grandma.
Your name, please.
Seems Edgeworth had a bit of trouble getting his witness to say their names.
Wendy, hold back, dearie. So, just call me...
Oh, okay. She's going on again. Okay. poor Edgeworth. He's still traumatized by the last case. And now he's being harassed by an old lady. Probably after this case, he will think about quitting the career.
Objection. I object to the witness talkativeness. Objection sustained. The witness will refrain from rambling on the stand.
I was just getting to the good part, dearie.
Perhaps we can get to the testimony?
No. The witness was stationed at the main gate on that day of the murder, correct?
Yes, I was.
And to get to the scene of the murder, someone would have to pass by you?
You know your stuff, dearie.
You may begin your testimony.
She sure is one hell of an old bag.
On the day of the murder, I arrived at the guard station at 1 PM. Poor old Dahmer and the rest had been doing a run through there since the morning. I had some errands to run that morning. Anyway, it was 1 when I got to the guard station. I was at the main gate from then until 5. Now the murder happened at 2 PM, right? Interesting to me, because a certain man walked right by me at 2 PM. It was Powers, the man right there, and he was heading towards the studio.
Okay. My throat. Doing so many voices is tiring. I can do it.
You saw the defendant then? Very well. Let's begin the cross-examination. Is that right?
Yes, Your Honor. Okay. Press. What errand do you have to do? What kind of errands?
Oh, well, you know.
Answer the question.
Actually, I was watching poor Hammer and Powers, observing, you know.
Observing? Weren't you supposed to be at the guard station?
Whispernapper!
What?
I told you I locked the gate, didn't I? I did my job.
I'm not sure your boss will see it that way.
Anyway, I always watch Hammer run through. Always. Never miss one in all my years.
Wow, I want to see a steel samurai run through too.
You could quit being a spirit medium and take up guard duty.
Not a bad idea.
Ok. Ok, presto. So, you saw Mr. Powers?
That's what I'll say. God walks in your head, Sonny? Nick, this is your chance.
Yeah, time to pull out the secret weapon.
I'll say it again, I saw him.
Ok, present. Let's go. Let's go! But we only have this as an evidence. We can't solve the case with only this.
Objection!
Let me get this straight, old bag. Miss Old Bag. You've been saying since yesterday that you saw Mr. Powers, correct? But you're talking about the man in this photo, aren't you?
Just a moment, Mr. Wright. Let me see that photo. What is this exactly?
None other than the steel samurai defender of New Old Tokyo. Miss Old Bag. Is this the Mr. Power that you saw?
Of course, didn't your mama teach her any sense, Sonny?
Hey, don't talk about my mom.
Anyone can plainly see that powers, right?
No, they can't. No, poor Edward is dying right now. He didn't told you, right? Gumshoe didn't told you that it was only the costume in the photo. I love this man. He's so angry right now. Well, I mean, I wonder. True, Mr. Power does play the role of the Steel Samurai. But that doesn't mean Mr. Power is the Steel Samurai.
I know that. I wasn't born yesterday.
No one in this court is accusing you of that, Witness.
He's having trouble calling her a hold bag, apparently.
However, you do not have proof that the person in this photo is Mr. Will Powers, do you?
No, see, old man. Of course I have proof.
Okay, what a situation. Even Edward is surprised. I love seeing their sprite doing this animation in combo. It's beautiful.
The prosecution would like to ask the old the witness. Please make know all the information in your possession ahead of time.
Oh, was I know everyone will be so nosy. You should be ashamed, all of you. Anyway, I showed that photo to a young detective. He told me this isn't any good as evidence, Paul. He didn't even give it a second look.
Poor Gumshoe. I wonder if he'll still have his job after this trial. I mean, I don't know how he still can have Gumshoe as a detective after the old one, but okay. Wow, old Windbag has left even Edgeworth speechless. She's good.
Let's hear about your proof then.
I never say anything I don't mean, mind you. That morning during the run-through of the action scene, I saw Powers trip and fall. He broke one of the props. It was a big mess. Apparently, he sprained his ankle pretty bad. Now, look at that picture. You can see he's dragging his leg, see? Clear as day. That's how I knew it was Powers. Happy?
Ooh.
So he had sprained his ankle? Very well.
Mr. Wright, you may cross-examine the witness. She got to be hiding something. I'll press her until she squeals. Let's go. Press. Pressing time. Press her. Okay. Rip and fall.
Yes, and to think he's supposed to be the steel samurai. What a loaf. So power sprain his ankle. I helped make it better for him, of course.
You helped make it better?
I kissed it when it hurt.
I don't wanna say anything. I'm not gonna say anything.
Let's just skip over that part, shall we?
Indeed. Where was the assistant then?
Oh, her? She was cleaning up backdrops, I think. She didn't know about power cycle.
You may continue your testimony. Okay. He broke a prop?
Sure did! His own samurai spear.
His samurai spear? The murder weapon? Oh, and it was broken? Oh lady, you've done it.
Lucky I was there with my duct tape to fix it.
This strikes me as a significant detail. I'd better write this down in the court record. The murder weapon, a break in the shaft, has been mended with duct tape.
Apparently he sprained his ankle pretty bad.
I'm gonna press everything. Was Mr. Power ankle badly sprained?
Not so bad that he couldn't walk around. He went to his dressing room to rest up after lunch.
To the nap.
Anyway, I saw him dragging his foot when he walked.
Dragging his foot. Okay. I think we heard enough. Haven't we, Your Honor?
Oh no, why? Well, there is one thing that bothered me.
Which is?
Where is the steel samurai costume now?
Actually, well, we couldn't find it. We're looking through. Anyway, that's not important. Oh, wow. The witness did see the steel samurai, yes. And it is clear that the person in the steel samurai suit was Mr. Power.
I suppose that's right.
Are you sure you're sure? Your Honor? Object! Hold it right there. We keep talking possibilities, but we have to agree that this photo showed the steel samurai. Nowhere in this photo can we see Mr. Will Powers.
The defense has a point. I also wonder if someone else not caught on camera could have killed Mr. Hammer. We have to consider that possibility also.
Then allow me to remove that doubt from your mind, Your Honor. Will the witness continue her testimony, please? No need to ask twice. The time of poor Hammer death was 2:30 p.m., true? The only person I saw go to the studio before then was Will Powers. No one else went there. If they had, I would have seen them.
So if no one else went to the studio, then it wouldn't have to be this steel samurai who did it.
Mr. Wright, you may cross-examine the witness.
What the hell am I going to cross-examine here? She didn't say anything more.
Are you absolutely sure? Oh, quiet, quiet, Sonny. Nobody suspicious looking post by at all.
Nobody suspicious looking, right.
Are you sure?
The witness has answered the question. Anyone going into the studio had to pass by the witness.
That's right, Sonny. You let them have it, edgy boy.
Edgy boy? I love to see how flustered he is while doing this story.
Well, the wild bag sure has balls. Or, well, you know what I mean.
Well, the wild bag have a way of skipping over important details after all. Or, for that matter, entirely forgetting them.
How convenient.
Something for you to look forward to, perhaps? He's dragging one leg. October... photo 2. Maybe I should present this. How do you know that?
Eh? Didn't I just explain it? I gave donuts to the young detective. And then, after some rubbish about it being a secret poll, he told me everything.
I see, the detective Gumshoe share his fellow officer fondness for donuts. Okay. I already pressed this one. What about before you go to the gas station?
You mean before one? Why? Everyone was in the employee area before then. And I locked the main gate so no one could get in. Not to mention...
what? Not to mention what? Okay, I'm going to present this. Hold on. Look at this photograph one more time. Let's go on. This photo was taken by the camera at the gate for the studio, correct?
Yes, sir, Sonny.
So, whenever anyone passed by here, it automatically takes a picture?
And here I thought you didn't know you hid from a hole in the ground.
Right, anyway. It's also true that the computer in the gas station record all security cam data.
Oh, you know, if you wanted to work at the studio, we might have an opening.
That very computer printed out this photo. Not that on the back of the photo are printed the words... October... okay. Photo 2.
Even I know that means it was taken at 2 PM on October the 5th. Really, Sonny?
Actually, I knew that too. The issue is a bit at the end where it say photo 2.
Photo 2?
The computer only held data for one photo on that day. Don't you think that's odd? Shouldn't this photo be photo 1, if it really was the only photo? Ooh.
Order, order! Please tell the court what you mean by this, Mr. Wright.
Actually, that's what I want to ask the witness. The evidence showed that no one but two people went to the studio that day. Yet, there is only data for one of the photos. Who could have erased the data for the other photo? Only someone with access, the security lady herself.
Watch your mouth, whippersnapper. The only person I saw that day was willpower.
But the camera on the gate fired twice. That means two people went by.
Well, yes, that's what it all seems to mean.
Can the witness explain this to the court?
I don't understand this new fungal computer thing. Edgy boy, help!
Believe me, I want to, but I don't know what this means either.
Some help you are. You're a whippersnapper too. Whippersnapper?
something the matter, Mr. Oldbeck?
Ah, that's right. I just remembered something.
Let me guess. Someone else passed by the gate. Someone ordered that the steel samurai?
Well, yes, I suppose you could put it that way.
I see. Your testimony, please.
Every day after I finish my guard duty, I have one other important job to do. I go through the photo recorded on the security computer and check them. I throw out any photo that doesn't look suspicious looking, you see? Come to think of it, now I remember throw out one photo that day.
Mr. Oldbeck, this is the first I've heard of this.
Well, of course, Sonny. I've only just remembered it. Wow.
Right. Anyway, Mr. Wright, please begin the cross-examination.
Well, I'd say this was a turn for unexpected, but I kind of expected this. Let's go. Uh-huh.
What job? Tell us. Another job?
That's right. I check all the people that passed by the main gate that day. I look close at every one of the photos the security camera takes.
Do you back up all of the security camera data?
Well, they keep telling me to, yes. But those computers are just so frustrating.
How exactly do you determine what isn't suspicion looking?
Oh, you can tell by looking at their faces, for the most part.
For the most part? This is a murder trial, Miss Oldbeck.
Well, I didn't touch that suspicion-looking willpower photo, did I?
I think she's missing the point.
Come to think of it, now I remember throwing out one photo that day.
Well, who in the heck was in that photo you're erased?
A fanboy.
A fanboy? A fanboy?
Still samurai fanboys, real freaks, if you ask me. They get information about the rehearsal from gosh nowhere. They're always hanging about, one was there that day.
Wait a second, didn't you just say no one else could get in? I left the main gate, so no one could get in. Those were your words.
Well, if you must know, a drain that goes into the employee area. The grate has been loose for a while. It leads outside and well, that's where they come in.
They come in through the drain?
I told you they were freaks. Oh, and...
And?
They're kids. Children. Whippersnappers.
Kids? So, on the photo that you erased...
It was a boy. Probably second or third grade.
What? Whoa. Ooh, my favorite toast started. Order. Let me get this straight. You saw two people pass the gate on their way to the studio that day. One was the steel samurai dragging his leg. The other was a boy who looked to be in about second and third grade.
Oh yes, well, we see his type there every day. Can't stop them, can't catch them.
A boy in second or third grade. I assume it will be hard, if not impossible, for a young boy to wield the samurai spear. Impossible, I think. It's quite heavy.
Right, as I said, I didn't pay him much mind. But where is the data?
But the steel was broken. So it wasn't big as it was before.
Nick, what's going on? I mean, the boy was there. That makes him a suspect.
Yeah, and that they're already trying to unsuspect him.
This court will take a 5-minute recess. I want the defendant and the prosecution to order this new information. And not forgetting vital information this time.
Ooh.
Fantastic. Because I needed to stop here. Wait. I need to stop. Sorry, Mr. Powers. We'll hear from you the next time. Okay, save. Phew. Okay. As I said already, I'm super happy that I don't know at all who is the culprit this time. But still, this make the rest hard because I'm not so clever in solving cases. So have patience with me. I still don't know who actually would have killed the other man. I think the killer isn't here. We still need to find the true culprit, but still probably the old bag. The Miss Holdbag is actually someone that helped him. I'm sure about this. I hope I'm sure. Okay. So now a boy came to the picture. I wonder if it's the one in the cover of the chapter, of the episode. Well, we'll discover it in the next episode on the next week. For now, I'll say to you bye bye, guys.